Ah, isn't it wonderful when you fall in love? Flowers smell more fragrant, birds chirp, you sing, rain falls and you decide, I needed a shower anyway. Well, what happens when your beau starts to turn into a creepy controlling stalker? What happens when your hottie turns into a high-maintenance, clingy prima diva? It's time to end that relationship ASAP. However, you can't just storm out spewing careless insults at these fragile souls. No, not if you know what's good for you. However, it's been said if your hand is in a lion's mouth, pull it out slowly. You've got to let them down easily. You've got to let them down politely. So we've risen to the occasion and we stepped up to the plate to give you the top 5 ways to politely break up with someone. We'll have you slipping that knot with minimum blowback. At number 5, we have the classic, "It's not you, it's me." This one line is credited with getting millions of people out of their romantic associations. Most of them from some real wackos. It's because this phrase takes the pressure off of the other person by stating in unclear terms, "I'm the one who has the problem. You're not crazy." Nope, not at all. Please don't hurt me. Be careful that you don't just throw this sentence around without having a real reference incident to make it a plausible confession. Have some supporting evidence to back up this strong main idea. Remind them of how you trashed their apartment or got them fired from their job because you made too many personal calls. If you don't provide some feedback evidence, you run the risk of being burned at the stake for using this common breakup clause. You will be called out for being uncreative and for insulting their intelligence. Says a friend of mine. What? She was clingy, okay? Anyway, next at number 4, a sentence that keeps you out of hot water and gives your partner something to think about. "I think I've been holding you back." This breakup line packs a pretty punch because it makes another statement that helps us feel better about ourselves. "You deserve better," is what the statement says. What more could a person want? Better yet, you can also include its clever cousin, "I need to work on myself," basically reminding them that they deserve better and you can't give it to them. Make sure you have an example to cite if you are asked for references. Now we start to venture into the darker side of breaking up with a crazy person. As you already know, or maybe you don't know, maybe I'm your cautionary tale here, it's okay. I will heal. No, seriously, the doctor said the bandages are coming off next week. But what you need to know is that most relationships with mental people deal with controlling stalker behavior. You kind of have to keep their antennas down or throw them a ball of yarn so they won't tear your head off as you plan your clean break. If you just try to break away, it may be too much for them to handle. And you definitely don't want that. They've already built this shrine to your awesomeness out of cat bones, and it's not like they can just un-euthanize Fluffy. Losing you would just create a huge hole in their hearts. So, number 3 gives them something to hold on to. Remember, think hand in lion's mouth. Let's be friends because I never want to lose you. Now I know what you're thinking. That will never work. Well, you would be surprised. It lets them feel as though they're worth something to you. And if you spin it right, you'll have them thinking they're so valuable to you that you would sacrifice even your romantic feelings just to make sure they're still a part of your life. And after all, that's what they want. So you can't really go wrong with that. You can also use the lesser cousin. "It would just hurt me if I ever hurt you." Cue the pouty eyes. If that doesn't work, you can always try number 2 and go straight for the excitement of doing a mind job on a mental person. It's like spinning a lopsided top. You know it doesn't spin for long, but you just can't look away, because with each wobbly turn, you don't know where it'll end up. Okay, that analogy sounds much safer than the reality. Well, here it is. Someone used this on me, so I know it works. She said, with the sweetest, most concerned voice, "I think you're in love with the feeling of being in love." Whoa. I was speechless for the rest of the conversation. Why, you may ask? Because my mind was blown. She managed to successfully tie up every single cell in my brain. I wasn't mad. I couldn't even get mad. I was too busy being confused. When someone drops this bomb on you, you're tossed between wondering if it's really true and what kind of evil person you are to have this sweet individual feel so unloved. I didn't even stand a chance. Hey, great job, we made it to number one, but before we get into it, it's time for a mini quiz. A multiple choice question that you get to answer for fun and bragging rights. In the movie, Sleeping with the Enemy, Julia Roberts' character learned what secret skill to plan her escape from her psychopathic husband? A. Swimming. B. Karate. C. Driving. D. Sailing. The answer is A. Swimming. She took swimming lessons to fake her death by drowning while swimming back to shore. Great job! Why don't you hit that thumbs up if you got it right? Let everyone know how many smart people watch these videos. Comment below and subscribe for more in the future. Now to number one. This is assuming, of course, that you've already got your escape plan in place. All you need to do is break up with your crazy boyfriend or girlfriend. The number one polite and safest way to break up with a crazy person is have a polite person do it for you. What, you thought I was gonna keep feeding you those normal people breakup tactics? Are you kidding me? Crazy means crazy. Trust me, you don't wanna get anywhere near them when you light those sticks of dynamite. Besides, it's 2020. We outsource everything. Do you really wanna do it yourself? You're still into DIY breakups? What is this, HGTV? You can go to Fiverr and just hire someone to break them up gently via video telegram. In the meantime, get your go bag, text your goodbyes, empty your bank account, and catch the next Greyhound out of town. It's time for a new identity. Make your great escape. Your safety is our top priority. You can just click the link to download my Avoid Crazy Dating Checklist to make better decisions in the future. Thank you for joining us on this journey through the top 5 polite ways to break up with someone crazy. Now you know this video can't possibly cover all the tactics out there. Leave a comment below if you heard of another tip that you're just itching to share. Remember, thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'd always be the first one to get the next top 5. If you know someone who needs this, share, because friends don't let friends live unaware.